YouTube, what's going on? Finally finishing up a SHOT Show. Actually still have some friends here. Gonna film some of the content, but I wanted to get this video made for you guys going over all the stuff that I found new over at SHOT Show and stuff that really grabbed my interest. Start off first with American Defense Manufacturing. As you guys know, I've done work with these guys in the past. They make awesome mounts, awesome rifles. It's a full AMBI rifle that I have. A lot of agencies here locally are switching over to them, which is awesome for them, congrats. But this year they debuted their new titanium mounts, which are quick detach, just like the previous mounts. However, these things are super light. In addition to that, they debuted their Flick 3, their Flick 5, and the Spec. The Flick 3, 3x magnifier made by them. The Spec, or Flick 5, sorry, is the 5x magnifier by them. And now they have their own new red dot. So a couple things to note about their Spec red dot. It's got a 16-hour shutoff. I'm not a fan of shutoffs, but I know a lot of guys on patrol like them because sometimes they'll leave their optic on patrol and forget about it before they get a shift. So these are scheduled to come out soon. Super stoked to check them out. Hopefully I'll be able to try some out since I've been working with those guys. But they've been working on these optics and the magnifiers for about the last 6 months, and they got them out the shot and showed them off, and I think they're pretty solid. Going back on the Howard Light Gear Pro that we showed you guys in the previous video, all the multi-cam colors, had a lot of questions about them. A couple things, they're going to be priced around $92, they'll start shipping in April, and they will be sold on all platforms to include Amazon. So you guys that have Amazon Prime, you can get them super quick. Next up, the Aimpoint ACRO-P1. A lot of questions about this red dot that is being used to mount onto pistols, especially Glocks. For me, honestly, just looking at it, it looks huge. However, a lot of people are taking a liking to it. I need to actually get some time behind it to give you guys a better impression, but the specs on it, it's a 3.5 MOA, 1 year battery life on a CR1225, and the MSRP is gonna be around $660. Looking at it, like I said, to me, it looks huge. However, with the actual dimensions of it or anything, it's not gonna get in the way of our holsters if you're running an RMR cut. It's blocked out correctly, I believe. But yeah, I wanna get some more time behind it, and there's a good picture out there that compares it to the Unity tactical mount with the T1. Very similar, and I know a lot of guys found that to be super beneficial running an actual more rugged optic on their handgun with the slide cycling mounted to it. Stopped over the CZ booth and talked to the guys about the P10F, the P10S, and the P10COR, all of the optics ready versions. Questions that we all wanted to answer. When are the optics plates coming out? All they could tell me was sometime in the first quarter. I did find them for all of you that reached out about the plates being available on the Czech Republic website. However, they won't ship to the US, so that's not an option. So the guys over at the booth, when I talked to them about purchasing a P10S and how I was picking it up the next day from Ventura Munitions, they pretty much blatantly called me a liar and told me they weren't available. Actually kind of rude, didn't appreciate it. So the next day I went and bought it, and I stopped by the booth and showed them the P10S OR. So, no apologies, their response was, well, I guess they shipped them while we were here. So I'm definitely a CZ fan, and I'm hoping it's just these two employees, but going to the booth, doing all the media stuff, I'm paying full price on this stuff, guys. Like, I buy these guns for the holster biz, but you guys know I'm a fan of the P10 lineup. Wasn't appreciated of that, and hopefully as we continue to do stuff with the CZ market, we'll deal with other people. One gun that really caught my interest, we stopped by the Sig Sauer booth and saw the new Sig 320X Compact. It's a 3.6 barrel. Essentially it looks like a compact frame on a subcompact slide, but it's got that X-Carry grip frame. So it feels really nice in the hand. I'm probably gonna pick it up this year for my own personal carry and rock it. I haven't really been a fan of the P320 series. Nothing against them, just for me. Just a few things that don't fit to, I guess, my grip and just the way I like to shoot. The X Compact will start shipping in April of this year, and again, like I said, I'll definitely be picking it up. So Enforce, the much anticipated debut of their new light that they kind of hid from everybody till SHOT Show. I was really impressed. Anodized housing, 4 different settings, constant momentary on, 1500 lumens, rechargeable. I think they just knocked it out of the park. I think it's an hour and 45 minute runtime. It's ambidextrous. I talked to Matt over there and says they're going to be coming out with an M-Lock style mount to get it even closer to the rail. So I'm definitely looking forward to checking this out. I think it's something that everybody's been wanting from Enforce, and hopefully they also go the same route with the handgun weapon lights. Price point on their new weapon light will be in the $200 to $220 range. and it should be out later this year. Stopping by the Palmetto State Armory booth, I wanted to check out the progress on the AKV 9mm. As you guys all know, I've been waiting to get my hands on this gun. I'm happy to report that they said all of the issues have been corrected and production is back to ramped up and going, so you just gotta check the website when they become available. I did also ask about the PSA 5, their MP5 variant, and even though they posted about having information, there was no information to give. They said that they don't know the price point they're gonna set, they don't know when it's gonna come out. It is still going to happen, they just don't know how much and when. Last year at SHOT Show, during the media event, I was able to shoot the new SCR from FightLight. While it looked gimmicky, like a pirate gun, I actually ended up liking it a lot. Mike and Danny both did as well, so I ended up picking one up for the shop. This year, they debuted the new MXR, super interesting platform. It's a 9mm pistol. The differences is that the upper receiver is actually the registered firearm, allowing multiple different caliber platforms to be installed by the two bolts in the bottom. I think it's a really cool idea. It's gonna give a lot of people the option to run different calibers in a PCC style setup or an AR style setup platform and a pistol caliber. For the 7-inch version, MSRP is gonna be around $1,500. The aluminum version will ship in April, the polymer version will ship in August. It'll be available in a 5-inch and 7-inch barrel platform, and currently it's only available in 9mm. All right guys, so that is the quick rundown on the entire SHOT Show week. Like I said, I only went over some of the new stuff I saw. This is my 13th or 14th SHOT Show, guys, so a lot of the stuff there is repetitive. However, still an awesome show. For me, it's getting to hang out with all my friends through social media that come in for the show. The parties were awesome, as you guys saw in the beginning. We also have that Flux Brace that everybody's been checking out on Instagram. We have some cool stuff coming up with that. And when I mean cool, I mean we have some fun projects we'll be doing. As always, guys, appreciate you checking out the video. Thanks for hanging out and checking out everything from SHOT Show. If you have any questions, leave them down below. I'll get to them as soon as I can, and I'll see you in the next video.